back at Rocky Mountain National Park, ignoring a traveler's mantra. Been there, done that, don't need to do it again. We're back because we love being here and doing that or this. Do it again, do it again, works as another traveler's mantra. So back at Colorado's Rocky Mountain National Park, we repeatedly enjoy the wonders put on by nature, like animals and hiking, plus a few people-produced preoccupations, such as comfortable places to sleep, eat, and hear from others. From nature, the park provides spectacular chances to see outdoor creatures and walk scenic trails. Up ahead is Hallett Peak. I used to call it Long's Peak, but it's not. It's a beautiful morning. Good for a hike.
Fern Lake Trail. Last time we were here, ultra heavy forest.
We don't usually stop at this place because we're always going somewhere else on the Trail Ridge Road, but it's closed. Over there, it says road closed. This is fun right now though, because these are some of the areas where we actually go. Like one time we hiked to Deer Mountain. And Fred calls it a piece of shit. He didn't really like that hike. And then we also often have been around the Fall River Road, which we like. Here's another of the places we go, which is Sheep Lakes, where we've seen moose. Right this minute, there's nobody down there because we can't see the reflection of cars. A lot of kind of fun areas to see here. A place we haven't stopped to read this, is that correct, Fred?
What?
We haven't stopped here before to read where
we haven't, but we have to look at Robin and her coveralls here.
Well, it's windy up here. Not cold, but windy.
It's cold, you wouldn't have all your winter jackets on.
That's a good point. That's the message for the chipmunks. Have they believed it?
I don't know what it says.
Do not feed the wildlife. It says do not feed you. Yeah, you're not allowed to climb me. And we're not allowed to feed you. That's the wildlife we're not allowed to feed. Poor guys. Life is sad. More Rocky Mountain Elk Show in the morning as we're driving to hike in the Bear Lake Corridor. Yep, a lot of elk.
Daddy's in the back.
Daddy is in back guarding. But we want to go hiking this morning. And we're not allowed to approach you. Oh well, he just went off the road.
No, he's on the road.
He's on the road?
There you go, my truck is not attempting anything other than pushing him. There you go.
This is in Rocky Mountain Park. What you have to do is slow down because you get a deer butt. If we ever make it to Fern Lake, Fred is really hungry. He's jealous of these guys. So we just tried our sunset dinner in the park. We didn't get a sunset, but hey, you might have liked some of our dinner, not all of it. No sunset, but there you are. Have a nice dinner. What were you saying? Yeah? Do you like Merlot? How about mahi-mahi? Mm-hmm. And elk meatloaf. We were looking for a sunset. Is there a sunset? Not really. Missed seeing how big his antlers are. They are big. But you can tell it's a moose. And he's not within Let's go charge Robin and Fred distance, we hope. There's a dewlap. Oh, he's turning. Really? You're leaving us? Bye. Thanks for showing up. Back in civilization, aka Estes Park, we relax at the 100-plus-year-old Crags Historic Lodge, at restaurants, or by wallowing in the atmosphere that inspired Stephen King's The Shining. In the land of Stephen King, well, that's Jack the Ripper, and we are in the underground of the carriage house of the Stanley Hotel. All right, we're going to see a magic show. You were part of the magic show over at the Stanley, which has its links to The Shining and Stephen King. Fred, you know what redrum is, right?
Murder.
So, been there, done that, and ready to do it again.